Hello, my name is Lubomira Dimitrova from Bulgarian Development Agency, and today we are going to have the lecture from our second module, which name is Roles and Profiles, Team Building Techniques and Conflict Prevention and Management, and we are going to speak about the conflict management and prevention. This is the second module from the Compass project. Before we go further with the lecture itself, I would like to introduce you to what we are going to speak about today. The first thing which we are going to discuss is what is conflict. Then we are going to see about the things which produce conflicts at the workplace, as well as the types of the conflict at the workplace and the different approaches toward the conflict resolution. We are also going to discuss on how to prevent conflicts. The first thing which we are going to speak about is we have to understand what the conflict is. The term conflict is characterized by a more varied content and definition theories. The essence of conflict, the word which we are going to use, you should know that it comes from Latin and it literally means hit and fight. It is determined as a situation of antagonistic relation between people in a group or between different groups. Psychologists stress that its contradiction is associated with a strong emotional relief. As an important and often present in the human relations process, conflict has been and continues to be the subject of numerous studies. In terms of its importance, it has a long competed two concepts. According to the first, conflict is destructive for interpersonal regulations relationship process and must always be off. The negative side is connected with the big emotionality and sometimes material losses from participation in it, with deposits fighting socio-psychologist climate in the workplace, worsening feeding quality and productivity at work, diminishing no interaction and trust between the people involved in the conflict and difficult recovery business relations. According to the second, conflict is constructive effect for human relationship and in fact, strangely enough, of under construction, sometimes even necessary. It affords a new information and clarity individual points for stylistics while boosting amendment and development, giving new ideas, adapt people to situations, destroy syndrome, obedience, remove the pressure of accumulated discontent is now shared. This means that the conflict can be both helpful and detrimental to teamwork. The destructive effect is it occurs when the runs are very high or very low level. Conflict floating of motive at a high level, leading to a severe stressful situation, destroys cohesiveness within the team and internal communication. The conflict have always existed, exists and will continue to exist. They are an integral part of human relationship. Opportunities for the occurrence is in every sphere of human activity, including in the medicine. Because they are unavoidable, it is important not to be avoided, but to be resolved effectively. For the proper functioning of that process should start with understanding and opportunity causes for the conflict. As a reason or an object of the conflict is defined concentration value, tangible and intangible, to possessions which seek opportunities. It can be the same but may be different from the object of the conflict. Objectivity or subjectivity perceives problem about which impact dispute emerges. Some reasons related to the circumstances and others, with the characteristics of the people involved in the conflict. The second step which we are going to discuss is why produces conflicts at the workplace. They can be defined in seven different reasons, which vary from different stakeholder interests, style of the manager, scope changes, schedule changes, project failure, disputes over the methodology use, or disagreement over the tools of communication. As it comes from the different stakeholder interest, the manufacturing stakeholder advocates for a simple, standardized product that will be easy to manufacture reliably. The marketing stakeholder advocates for a complex product that allows for extensive customization by customers. At the first glance, these stakeholders appear locked in conflict. As for the style of the manager, consider the case of a project manager who takes a disciplined approach to managing projects and holds staff accountable. Depending on how this management style is communicated, unproductive tension and conflict could threaten the project's success. As for the scope of the changes, imagine you have put 3 weeks into building a plan to install network infrastructure in a new office building. Then you receive a scope change specifying you need to switch to a new type of equipment. Your first reaction may well be an anger at the stakeholder. After all, you will not have to render all the work. As for the schedule changes, what comes to mind when you read the word crashing? Perhaps you imagine carnage on the road or your computer failing you at an important moment. Yet crashing is a best practice defined in the PMBOK guide glossary, a technique used to shorten the schedule duration for at least incremental cost by adding resources. In practice, crashing can mean overtime work. Absent support and planning a crashing schedule changes will trigger conflict. Now let us discuss the project failure. Working on a doomed project is discouraging. Even if a project fails or it is cancelled due to external conditions, for example a regulatory change, change in financial costs or something else, recriminations and blame are inevitable. Project cancellation may cause significant conflict between the sponsor and the project manager. As for the disputes over the methodology use, we can say that change requires are an important tool in managing projects. What if somebody on the project team submits a change request to request an additional resource and it's declined? That team member may be angry at having to make do with the limited resources. As for the disagreement over the tools of communication, many projects rely on vendors to deliver vital projects and services. In many cases, the vendor and project team have different interpretations. Resolving these disagreements is time-consuming and throws the project behind schedule. Whether you disagree about quality requirements, warranties or liability, vendor disagreements are a common source of project conflict. The next thing which we are going to speak about are the types of conflicts and the workplace. Commonly, they are divided into two groups. The first is employee versus employee and the second one is employee versus manager. When it comes to employee versus employee, according to the business trainer Karen Watts, the best way to deal with workplace conflict is to offer conflict resolution before the workplace environment becomes hostile. Since this often does not happen, Karen advises using a quickly, quietly and closely method of resolving conflict. This means taking the problem immediately before it gets worse and talking out the early shot of others. When the two employees sit down to talk, they should remain calm and attack the issue, not each other. The most positive way to do this is to use the first person when explaining your viewpoint. Instead of "you said this" or "you did that," use statements that begin with "I feel." This will keep the other person more respective to what you have to say. If the conflict is serious and the employees have no conflict resolution experience, a supervisor or a human resource person should be called in to mediate. As for the employee versus manager, dealing with employee versus manager conflict can be challenging. The proper way to deal with this type of workplace conflict will depend on the cause. If it's a communication problem or a misunderstanding of expectations, a simple meeting to clear the air might be all that needed to resolve the problem. Showing initiative and willingness to improve can go a long way in impressing a frustrated manager. In the case where an employee feels harassed by the superior, it is a good idea to involve human resources. In this case, we are going to see a couple of approaches developed by Rumor Mill how to deal a passive-aggressive behavior. The passive-aggressive behavior, such as a rumor spreading, can be difficult to prove and frustrating to the recipient of the negative behavior. The conflict may have started as a venting and turned into a full-fledged rumor, or it may have been started on purpose. This can create a hostile work environment for the affected employee and make performing everyday tasks difficult. If you are positive who started the rumor, it is best to go directly to the source and confront them. Remember to use the I feel statement, as we already discussed, even though you may not be tempted to respond emotionally. If rumors turn into direct confrontation or name-calling, Crampton says asking the simple question, "What do you mean?" may diffuse the situation by forcing the name-caller to back up his or her claims on the support. When a harassment gets out of control or makes you feel threatened, it is best to inform human resources as soon as possible. This way, they can help you get onto the bottom of the problem. They can also remind the aggressor that their behavior is inappropriate and could have consequences. When it comes to the delicate conflict, or when the workplace conflict crosses the line, well, in that case, when workplace conflict crosses the line into a purposeful harassment because the fellow employee's gender, race, religious affiliation, sexual orientation or disability, it immediately becomes a human resources issue. It is important to have the incident or incidents documented in case of further action is needed. Watts advises the errant employee to be reminded of the seriousness of his or her actions and to be sent to sensitivity training. If the behavior continues, the employee should be terminated. Conflict in the workplace can be kept to a minimum when a business takes the time to educate its employees about the proper conflict resolution. Employees should feel empowered to solve minor conflicts on their own. If the conflict can be resolved between two people, a supervisor or an HR representative should be called in to mediate. When it comes to the different approaches towards conflict resolution, we can easily define them into 5 different groups. They can be defined as awareness of the conflict parties that have the interest, the opposing interests, the belief both sides that the other was hurt or intended to hurt their interest, to leak in interaction between the parties, or the direct action performed on both sides that harm the interest of the other party. The intensive study of international conflict begins with the wave of social unrest swept the world in the 60 years of this century. Researchers have offered various definitions of conflict. It is seen as an interactive state occurring in incompatibility, disagreement or differences in between social actors, and it includes communication incompatibility goals. Toms defines it as a continuous process that begins when one side believes that the other is harmed or hurt something she wants. Mathier and Ingvesen add to this definition, believing that the conflict can be seen as a process of cognitive bargaining during which the subject of the dispute and user framework should be negotiated. Bargaining in a process caused by at least two parties trying to reach common decisions among multiple alternatives when their original performance differ. Krugowski and his colleagues argue that the conflict could be seen as a conflict scheme, whose core lies in the belief that the participants countries have incompatible goals. This can be identified five main characteristics of the conflict. As we already said, they are opposing interests, awareness of the conflict parties that have an interest, believe both sides that the other was hurt or intends to harm their interests, leak in interaction between the parties, or a direct action performed on the both sides that harm the interest of the other party. Conflicts arise when men want to engage in activities incompatible with their needs and interests, when he has behavioral preferences whose satisfaction is inconsistent with the performances of the other side, where there is a limited amount of highly demand resources, like money, space, job opportunities, and so on. Differences in attitudes, values, skills, and goals. This social norm can also be the basis of a long personal conflict where both sides want to even the score and revenge, eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth. False attributions for behavior of others can lead to anger, hurt, and resentment that can easily escalate into conflict. Studies have shown that ineffective communication is the biggest source of conflict in the work environment. Often constructive criticism can be perceived as a potential attack, and that's why many people are reluctant to say negative things to avoid unpleasant indicators. As Ryan quotes some examples of conflict behavior, intervention rivalry, verbal abuse, tension and frustration, which can annoy you. Most people associate conflict with something very unpleasant and bad and think that they should be avoided. Not least those who believe that the good relationship should not be any conflicts. More studies, however, suggest that a failure to constructively dealing with a conflict is what destroys relationships, not their presence. For this reason, Johnson's details touches the potential benefit of a conflict. Now we are going to the last step of our today's lecture, or how should a conflict be prevented? Conflicts at the workplace can not only spoil your mood, but also have a negative impact on the career onto your TV. For to avoid clashes with colleagues, consumers and management, you need to choose the correct behavior strategy. So first of all, you need to be flexible. It is not necessary to go into open conflict, defining his point of view. Be a diplomatic person, then you will be able to find a compromise between respecting your interest and preserve the normality of the workplace. In any situation, try to smooth corners and find the most advantageous position. It is not always necessary to go ahead with the scandal and defend their opinions on any future crisis. In this behavior, will not use. Try to avoid confrontation with the leadership. Open criticism of his superiors, gossip about the boss, and the expression of dissatisfaction with the policies of the bureaucracy cannot bring you what the trouble and dismissal. As for the rules, in order not to provoke any conflicts, try to follow the rules of ethics. Don't raise your voice at work and control their negative emotions. The workplace must prevail business relations. There is no place for losing your nerves. Don't cross the border to communicate with colleagues and partners. Knowing your attitude may irritate the others. The distance helps to avoid the appearance of negative emotions from other people. Be the colleague to who is always nice to talk to. Respect the space of others. Follow the unspoken rules of behavior in a group. Be tactful. Participate in events organized by your employer and show your loyalty to the company. As for the prevention of the conflict, you must make sure that the dissatisfaction with each factor at work is not expanding. If you are not satisfied with unacceptable working conditions or additional obligations, it is better to discuss these issues with your leader. Otherwise, irritation will grow and at some point you can hang on to your own nerves, and in this case you're going to explode, and this is not an outcome which you're going to reach to. Do not succumb to productivities. If your team has a people who love to make jokes at the expense of others, adequately react to their attacks and their addresses, and not let them get to your balance. When you realize that this part of the manipulation enemies will be easier to take the easy jokes to your colleagues, and you will keep yourself calm and not going into further trouble. Be conscientious in feeling their obligations to work. But don't forget that sometimes mistakes committed by employees or their disregard of their work could lead to complaints and conflicts. Try to take the job on time. Raise the level of their professional skills and attitude to work with seriousness and responsibility. Well, I must say that this is the end of our today's lecture. Before we finished, I would like you to have the readings for your today's lecture. You can approach them on the links which are available. You should have in mind that both of the readings won't take you more than 1 hour of your time. If you're interested into this topic, I'm letting available the literature which I used for today's lecture. In this case, you can go further and find out more. Please also have in mind that this is only one part of the huge field of human resource management, so don't be afraid to use the internet and find out more. Well, that was it for me from today, and if you have any questions, please don't hesitate to contact me on my email for further information. I wish you good luck and see you next time.